Hey, here are five stupid things I've noticed about Jesus. He drew no distinction between thought and action. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 27 and 28, Jesus says, quote, "Ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, Thou shalt not commit adultery. But I say unto you that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her hath committed adultery with her already in his heart." That's a pretty horrifying moral standard when you think about it for about half a second. He's saying that there is no distinction between thinking about doing something and actually doing something. That's just a horrible philosophy for two reasons. First, it means that the only way you can avoid being a bad person is by not only refraining from doing bad things, but also refraining from thinking about doing bad things, which is pretty much impossible. Second, it means that thinking about doing something positive, but not doing it, is just as good as actually doing it, because you've already committed a good deed in your heart, after all. I know lots of Christians who have mastered that one. He showed no respect for other people's property. In the Gospels of Matthew and Mark, we find the story of Jesus cursing a fig tree, causing it to wither and die because it doesn't have figs, even though figs aren't even in season. And it's not his tree. There's also the story in Luke 8 of Jesus casting demons out of a possessed man and allowing the demons to go into a herd of pigs, pigs which promptly run into a lake and drown. Not Jesus's pigs either. You know, why does Jesus have such a hard time not destroying shit that doesn't belong to him? He publicly mistreated his mother for no good reason. Earlier in the 8th chapter of Luke, Jesus is told that his mother and brothers are nearby and want to see him, and Jesus blows them off, saying that his followers are his real family. Jesus, dude, your mother was a saint. Literally. I mean, I'm sure you were busy and all, but how much of a prick do you have to be to give your mother the fuck off after she miraculously conceived and virginally birthed your ass? You know, most women would have told that angel of the Lord to go fuck himself when he showed up talking about impregnating them with the semen of God or whatever the fuck it was. Not Mary. She knew that people would think she was a slut, maybe even her old man, but she went along with it anyway. And this is the thanks she gets. From her own son. Fuck you, Jesus. He was the prototypical cult leader. Let's see, he established himself as the ultimate authority. He claimed to be divine. He demanded control over the actions and the thoughts of his followers, control which he promised to maintain beyond the limitations of this earthly life. He promised his followers unfathomable rewards for their devotion, and he told them that everything he asked of them was asked out of love. Who am I talking about? Nope, not him. Nope, wrong again. Not it. Not it. Not it. No. Whoa! No. There you go. Go back one. There you go. That's the guy. He's a myth even if he was real. Debates over whether or not Jesus even existed can be interesting and fun, but ultimately I think those who argue fervently for one side or the other miss a very important point. If there was a historical Jesus, he was nothing like that guy. Okay, maybe not nothing. I mean, you would expect that they would share some points in common. The historical Jesus would have bore some faint resemblance to the figure in the New Testament, but the actual details of his birth and life and death would likely have been very, very different from that which most people know. He probably didn't say most of the things attributed to him, and it's very unlikely that he was a god or the son of a god or in any other sense divine. That Jesus, the Jesus who was born of a virgin, who worked miracles, and who rose from the dead to conquer death, hell, and the grave, is just as imaginary as that guy. Just as imaginary, but not nearly as cool. Can he swing from a thread? No, he can't, 'cause he's dead. He died way back in the first century. I think it's elementary. JC ain't no Spider-Man. The hardest part is only picking five. Catch you next time.